But yeah, eventually not good enough. And and that's how Bong said, like, hey, you can't even win. Why not just come join me? yeah. I guess initially, AgriMind started up with a very clear idea that we are focusing just for World Esport games, which is quite a huge IP. The startup of AgriMind is mainly focused on this project because it will be quite a long-term project. So we start up at 2018, if I'm mistaken. Mm-hmm. Right. The process is very challenging. Mm,
tedious.
Yes, also tedious, mm. But yeah. But we definitely enjoy the process handling this kind of event. Mm. Definitely is kind of a good portfolio for our company and also like for ourselves as well. Yeah.
Basically, it's not just us that want to transition. It's also like the whole, you know, whole ecosystem like esports and then also the game development.
The
current trending, you also will be forced to shift. It's not like you want to stick to the game itself. Also, like the trend now, the younger generation, everyone own a smartphone, or it's cheaper to own a smartphone instead of a high-end PC. Yeah. So, and also like the funding given by the game developers directly to host a tournament is actually more like it's a different era already lah now, not like our era.
Primarily in the whole Southeast Asia ecosystem, yeah. All are shifting to mobile gaming right now. Of course, there are still some communities are still having PCs played, still remaining playing Dota, but somehow in overall Southeast Asia, we are seeing the number is dwindling in terms of a PC, and even console somehow still able to remain to keep their community. But mobile gaming is definitely the way forward.
Well, this is esports.
Things change very fast.
Yeah. Events, actually, you really need experience and also a team. It's not a solo part of like typical events, like what we call a normal launching event. Yeah, those also will have difficulties. But in esports, it's really like you have to solve the problem immediately, like internet, player. So if you compare to a traditional sports game like badminton or what, they won't have server update or whatsoever, game server update or internet DC or whatsoever. Basically, if can work together, we will. We will work together. And same to like WESG, our own IP. We can't do everything like just us three. So we will bring in others team. That one is confirmed. And expert lah. Most importantly is you are expert in certain field, like maybe sound and light or internet as well, the infra. A lot of things actually BD is the one to deal with sponsorship, everything, right? But the back end is very, very important. That's why we very, not say we lah, I personally very appreciate that back end people who helped us before. Yeah. Not say BD not good lah, it's just that
the amount sales, of preparation.
The amount of preparation, actually project manager, the person who are the project manager, he's quite stressed. Cause everything, even the player fuck up also, you find the project manager. For example, Jason, he's expert in marketing. So he will understand what's League Op doing. Like he will understand what YY doing. So YY will understand what are we doing. Then I will also understand what they both doing. We will know, like if let's say I handle the project. So this one is more general in what esports lah. So like I will know like, okay, today what's the marketing plan to be posted on Facebook or social media. So I will need a report to a client. So and then if let's say, oh, he has what problem. So I know how to explain. It's not he's the one to go explain to a client. It's same to League Up. So and this the communication, that's why in esports event, you can't just focus on your role. This one quite wide. Yeah. It's not like it's not like you need to do a lot of things. Your knowledge need to cover a lot.
I think initially, right, before the structure of esports was well built, the ecosystem, I think most of the people who worked earlier, like let's say if you join the career 4 or 5 years back, you know, in this industry, it doesn't have a fixed role. At certain points, you are going to do everything. And that's how you pick up all the skills, I would say.
There's no such thing as BD back then.
Yeah.
As I remember. Yeah.
Only the boss.
Only the boss.
The boss will do the sponsorship.
And then a bunch of crews.
Yeah.
Like that only.
Then we all like firemen.
After like few years now, then we look back, definitely that trained us well, right? I would say.
Yeah.
Definitely what you have learned, like I would say the best way to learn something is get your hand dirty. So everything, if you go and practice yourself, you're definitely not gonna forget about it.
Actually, to me, any LAN event
that
have crowd, we will feel the hype already. Mm-hmm. Because although it's not our event, but as long as the audience appreciate to come to the venue itself to support, actually quite touching. Because for Malaysian, a lot of past previous events, a lot of ticket is giveaway.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no one willing to spend to buy ticket to go watch esports tournament that you can watch on Twitch online.
Mm-hmm. Generally, initially when esports started, also start from community. It's not from corporate.
Yeah, everything start from a bunch of people sharing the same hobbies. Yeah. Then we feel really fun. Play together, to meet each other, to play a game together.
And that's how the community tournament started as well.
The community. Slowly, the community merged with another community and merged with another. Then there comes the bigger community and here we are. Okay?
The worst esports event.
There's only one.
Yeah, there's only one.
I think me and Eric only think of that.
Every one of us involved, I think.
I think of that.
Involved in sense of helping to solve the problem because it involved other country player to fly over to participate in that tournament. And
management is too messy.
Yeah, the management is very messy. So
we volunteer. We even volunteer, right?
It's volunteer, but then you need your fame. Like people fly here, other country player fly here, they will feel that, hey, what the hell is this, man?
Why Malaysian give me this kind of
treatment?
Treatment, you know. It tarnish, it might not be our business because it's not our event, but eventually it tarnish the whole country reputation of the industry as well.
Also, our partner or contractor involved in it, so they also seek for help. That's why, if you don't have
capability.
Yeah, don't host an international tournament. At least for Southeast Asia. No one willing to spend like billion on like esports. Cause to be honest, for all the EO out there now, you can see basically a lot of esports tournament within these 2 years, maybe COVID, we don't know, but a less IT brand sponsor. You all can see, like let's say any tournament, even us, the upcoming tournament, we don't find IT brand. Suddenly, you see why is Engine Oil coming as a sponsor, but we are doing racing. Yeah, cause it related to more real life product. So it's a different. You need to find a way. Because IT brand, they doing sponsorship on branding, but then eventually one day their branding is done.
Yeah, already established.
So they already don't need all this. So how are you going to get investors in your events or whatsoever we call.
I think the most direct and fastest way to get contact to event organizers, the EO, definitely is being player itself. So that's how I get into EO, because initially I was still a player. But yeah, eventually not good enough. And and that's how Bong said, like, hey, you can't even win. Why not just come join me? yeah. From what we are focusing on, like let's say we are getting a videographer, definitely we are still looking at their skills on editing. And if you are looking for a project manager or something like that, we are still mainly focused on his project management and everything. Even though he is not a person who play games or he's not in esports, but eventually he can pick it up from there. But still we are mainly focused on that. But if let's say he have the gaming knowledge or he have knowledge in esports, definitely would be a plus point. But it's not necessary, I would say, when we go to corporate level.
Back then it was a lot of R&D.
Yeah.
A lot of R&D on all sorts of tasks.
You know, it's more like back then, we are going into a forest. There's no roots, there's no marks, everything. We go and figure it out, and we found the best route already, and we are doing all the markings for the people. So nowadays, people are just, oh, there's a marks already. We can easily reach the peak just following this path.
Nowadays, there's no such thing as Pau Kalia executive no more.
No one want to do. You hire intern 2 days later, he tell already.
Yeah, I'm so worried about it.
Nowadays, no more already. Nowadays, I'm more specific and
No one
clearly describe.
No one will willing to do like previous how we did last time.